Everything we do it with energy. Everything I do it with energy. And today, I'm going to tell you a story. I will start it with a famous Serbian scientist to pay homage to my roots. In 1882, during a walk in Austria where he studied, Nikola Tesla came up with the idea of the alternating current motor. It is a key enabler of our daily use of energy, even today. That same year, the world's energy consumption was about 9,000 terawatt hours. It's roughly a third of what the US consumes today. Nowadays, the global annual energy consumption is 20 times higher, 180,000 terawatt hours. It's the amount of energy that could power the shiny city of Las Vegas for 5,000 years. And it does not stop there. The US Energy Information Administration predicts a further 50% increase by 2050. The world is very energy hungry, and it is becoming even more so. And this is not only a long-term challenge, but one we are facing today. We need energy to be affordable, accessible, secure, but above all, we need energy to be green. At ENGIE, our purpose is to accelerate the transition towards carbon-neutral economy. We're probably the first global energy company that has started this journey in 2015. It marks a significant chapter in the book of our 180-year history. In the old world, we had a relatively simple and centralized mix of energy supply, with sources like coal, oil, and natural gas. There was abundance of these resources, they were mostly affordable, and we didn't worry that much about burning fossil fuels. Today, we live in a different world. We're already witnessing severe weather events, forest fires, floods, droughts, across geographies. We don't have much time to deal with this climate crisis. Every day counts. Our energy system is also becoming a lot more decentralized as we are shifting our mix to renewables and the main energy carrier to electricity. So why am I telling you all this? And why here at the AWS stage? It's because data and digital play a key role in this energy transition. And let me illustrate how with three examples. First, most renewable energies are intermittent by nature, as the sun does not always shine and the wind does not always blow. To optimize and forecast production levels of our renewables, we use a lot of data and advanced analytics. For predicting equipment failure before it occurs, we use predictive analytics, machine learning, and, of course, the Internet of Things. Second example, as we decentralize, we have an increase in small, local energy producers and consumers within so-called microgrids. You can think of the houses with solar panels on the roofs, or electric cars using their batteries to store energy. To balance supply and demand in this very complex system, we need to use a real-time energy management system. And to track sources and usages of energy, we can use blockchain. Third, let's switch from supply to demand. The best way to minimize the environmental impact is to reduce the energy consumption. At ENGIE, this is exactly what we do to help people and companies on that quest. And sometimes it is as simple as ensuring that HVAC and lighting are on only when people are present, for which, you can guess, the IoT plays a central role again. Now, you may wonder what a 180-year-old company has in common with a digitally native tech company like AWS. For a non-digitally native company like ENGIE, centralizing our data and ensuring its quality and availability was the first and key step on our cloud journey. Today, we have a common data hub where we store more than 1 petabyte of data across and use that across more than 1,000 projects. Our common data hub was built on Amazon S3, which provides the scalability, availability, security, and performance we need. We also use Amazon Redshift, allowing us to query semi-structured data and make use of analytics. We use many other AWS resources, like Kinesis Data Streams, Glue, Athena, and SageMaker, which allows our developers and data scientists to train and deploy data machine learning modules with speed. They all help to make our clean energy more efficient. As an example, in the heating and cooling networks that we run for cities like Paris, Dubai, or Barcelona, these tools power our dedicated digital solution that help Barcelona, for example, to reduce this network's energy usage by up to 15%. And it's just a start. Additionally, we have experienced 60% savings on runtime in the cloud by automatically scaling up our infrastructure during working days and scaling it down during weekends and at nighttime, which, of course, helps us to save the precious energy. And that is exactly how the relationship between ENGIE and AWS creates a very exciting flywheel effect. AWS technology enables ENGIE to create digital platforms that help us to accelerate the energy transition. And ENGIE provides green electricity to AWS from our solar and wind farms in the UK, US, Italy, and France, helping Amazon to reach their goal of powering the operations with 100% electricity, which is renewable. So what does this all mean for you? As we all scale up our digital platforms and solutions, our digital real estate will continue to grow, and so will its energy usage. Therefore, it is imperative that we power it with green energy to ensure that we minimize its carbon footprint. If I close my eyes and peek into the future, I see a world in which everybody has access to the energy they need. Accessible, affordable, secure, and green. To get there, we need innovative solutions. But more than that, we need the best and the brightest. Today's Nikola Teslas of all genders and all backgrounds to make that a reality. We need everyone to play their part. So join us, and let's work together to be at the right side of history. Because every day counts. Thank you.